All right, viewers, as usual, right on the top of 7 at 7, I want to take our viewers through figures in terms of numerically where India stands with its fight against COVID-19. Right now, where we stand, viewers, in our total active positive cases across the country, the total number is 4,44,746. We've seen till now across the country 1,34,699 deaths. Let's break it down state-wise. The state of Maharashtra continues to dominate with the highest import of active cases standing at 84,238. Till now, the state of Maharashtra, viewers, has recorded one third of the national death toll, 46,683. Cutting across to the state of Kerala right now, with total active cases of 64,539, Kerala has not fortunately seen a high death toll, standing at 2,095. Delhi, which many would suggest right now, is in a state of COVID emergency with active cases at 38,501. The deaths is a worrying factor, with Delhi recording till now 8,621. Delhi of late has seen a very high mortality rate, clocking in over 100 deaths per day due to COVID. We're going to keep a keen eye on all developments. This was a graphic which was, the figure that was recorded just about a short while back by our producers right here on India Today. All right, now let me take you to our top focus story on 7 at 7, which comes from the eastern coast between Puducherry and Tamil Nadu. A red alert, viewers, has been sounded in the southern states as Cyclone Nivar is inching closer. These are the latest visuals that are coming in, with wind speed recording of about 60 kilometers per hour. And even now, we are 5 hours away from the cyclone making landfall. Now, the landfall is likely between Mamallapuram near Chennai and Karaikal in Puducherry tonight, with a wind speed of 110 to 140 kilometers per hour. The cyclone is likely to turn into a very severe cyclone storm when it makes landfall, and that is the worrying point. The air operations at Chennai International Airport have already been suspended. All roads leading to Marina and Basant Nagar beaches have been closed temporarily. The security has also been increased and people have been told not to venture towards any beaches. As a precaution, Chennai Corporation has ordered removal of all hoardings ahead of Cyclone Nivar. A public holiday has been announced by the Tamil Nadu government in 13 districts tomorrow. Meanwhile, neighbouring Puducherry, which might actually face the maximum brunt of the cyclone, has imposed prohibitory orders under Section 144. 25 NDRF teams have been deployed and 22 teams are on standby to assist operations.
I'm standing near the Gandhi statue, the iconic Gandhi statue in Puducherry. And what we can see here, unfortunately, the visuals on the camera might not do justice, but what we can see here is that the sea levels are increasing, the waves are increasing. And, we have been told not to venture towards this part of the region much, because this is a kind of a place where the eye of the storm might be coming in. Already, Section 144 is in place and all precautionary measures like relief camp centers, etc., have been put into place.
The impact on Andhra Pradesh does not seem to be on the higher side yet. So the impact will be mostly on some coastal districts of Tamil Nadu, about 6 or 7 of them, and the entire Pondicherry area. Right now, for the last 24 hours or more, the NDRF teams and along with the state administration, the local and district administrations are involved in evacuation, awareness drives, taking people to safety, giving them survival kits, etc., and generally making them aware as to what to do and what not to do. But mostly, I think the impact would be in these 6-7 districts on the coastal northern Tamil Nadu, along with Pondicherry.
I want to cut across right now immediately to my colleague Nolan Pinto, joining us from Pattinapakkam in Chennai. Nolan, what are you reporting? What do you see around you? What time is the landfall expected?
Very close to the Marina Beach, where I'm standing. Outside, the police have made sure that everybody goes inside. are coming up with their own safety. It was one of the finest ministries.
All right, you know, Nolan, I'm sorry to come in, and if you can hear me, I totally understand. You're right now in an area which is seeing a very high wind speed. We can barely hear you. There's a lot of disturbance. We're going to try and get in the very latest. But right now, what seemingly the news that is coming in suggests that this cyclonic storm might turn into a severe cyclonic storm as well. The wind speed has already picked up. You just saw that report. My colleague Nolan struggling to get through in terms of his audio, because the wind speed where he is, which is on the peripheries of Tamil Nadu, the wind speed there is being recorded over 60 kilometers per hour. When this cyclone slams into the east coast there, it's expected to howl at a wind speed of 140 kilometers per hour. All right, let's cut across now to the city of Hyderabad, where a local municipal election, viewers, has got the national stage. In terms of high-octane political drama being witnessed, the heavy weights of the Bharatiya Janata Party booming in Hyderabad for municipal elections. Now, all of this ahead of the December Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation elections, political temperature soaring. BJP Telangana Chief Bandi Sanjay Kumar, while addressing a roadshow, proclaimed his party will carry out surgical strikes in the old city area of Hyderabad to drive out illegal Rohingyas. On the other hand, Owaisi has hit back at the BJP, daring the Prime Minister to do a surgical strike in territories he alleged are occupied by China in Ladakh. Telangana Minister K.T. Rama Rao also tweeted asking the BJP if they will kill crores of Hyderabad people just for the sake of a few votes. Hyderabad civic polls are slated for the 1st of December. The run-up to the elections has witnessed a high-octane campaign.
ఈ ఎన్నికల్లో భారతీయ జనతా పార్టీ మేయర్ అభ్యర్థిగా గెలిచిన తర్వాత బిడ్డ నీ పాత బస్సులో నీ పాత బస్సు మీద సర్జికల్ స్ట్రైక్ చేసి వెళ్ళా ఈ రోహింగ్యాలను ఈ పాకిస్తాన్ నా కొడుకులను తరిమి తరిమి కొట్టే బాధ్యత భారతీయ జనతా పార్టీ తీసుకుంటది. రోహింగ్యాల ఓటర్ లేని ఎన్నికలు జరగాలి. పాకిస్తాన్ లుచ్చన్న కొడుకుల ఓట్లు లేని ఎన్నికలు జరగాలి. ఆఫ్ఘనిస్తాన్ కొడుకులైనటువంటి ఓటర్లు లేని ఎన్నికలు ఈ భాగ్యనగర్ లో జరగాలంటే అది కేవలం భారతీయ జనతా పార్టీ ద్వారా మాత్రమే సాధ్యమన్న విషయాన్ని గుర్తుంచుకోండి.
ఈ ఆప్ కిస్ పే సర్జికల్ స్ట్రైక్ కరేంగే యే తో భారత్ కే లోగ్ హై నా మై బీజేపీ సే కహ రహా హూం కి జో భీ ఆ స్టేట్మెంట్ దియా मैं प्राइम मिनिस्टर से बोल रहा हूं ये बात सच है कि चीन की फौज लद्दाख में दिपसांग प्लेन इलाका है 970 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर पर चीन बैठा हुआ है. मिस्टर मोदी वहां सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक नहीं करेंगे, मुंह से चीन का नाम नहीं लेंगे, वहां से निकालने की बात नहीं करेंगे.
भारतीय जनता पार्टी हैज कंसिस्टेंटली मेंटेन्ड that this great land of ours rightfully belongs to every Indian citizen, whereby we need to ensure that the rights of Indian citizens are protected against illegal immigrants. Hence the fact that the TRS and the MIM will not stand by the average Indian but choose to stand by illegal immigrants so that they can politically gain is shameful.
All right, if there's a high-octane election being fought, a municipal election in Hyderabad, let's move up to the tectonic election that is going to be witnessed in the state of West Bengal in just 5 months from now. West Bengal has turned into a complete political battleground. After accusing BJP of bringing outsiders and goons in Bengal, Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has now targeted Home Minister Amit Shah. Mamata Banerjee said that the Home Minister bought his food from a five-star hotel to eat with tribals, also accusing the BJP of lying and cheating tribals. Mamata's scathing attack comes amidst her Bankura visit, where she was reviewing the situation in tribal areas.
স্বরাষ্ট্র মন্ত্রী এখানে এসে বাইরে থেকে রান্না করা খাবার নিয়ে এসে থাকছেন ফাইভ স্টার হোটেলে, নিয়ে আসছেন বাসমতি চাল পোস্তর বড়া. একজন ব্রাহ্মণ ঠাকুর দাঁড়িয়ে বলছে অন্যান্যরা যেগুলো খাবে সেগুলো তদারকি করছি. তার মানে ওনার খাবারটা আলাদা আসবে আর বাইরে ওনার কিছু সাঙ্গপাঙ্গ আসবে, তাদের তো পাশে বসাতে হবে, তার জন্য ব্রাহ্মণ ঠাকুর নিয়ে এসে তপশিলি বাড়ি ধার নিয়ে লজ্জা করে না রান্না করে নিয়ে এসছে।
পিতাজি ইয়ে বতা দে কি পহলে বঙ্গাল মে কে থা আর ও কহাঁ পর লেকার আই। तो केवल और केवल डिटोरिएशन है, चाहे लॉ एंड ऑर्डर की बात है, चाहे इंडस्ट्रियल डेवलपमेंट की बात है, चाहे रोजगार की बात है, चाहे सीमा पर गाय तस्करी की बात है, चाहे घुसपैठ की बात है, हर जगह डिटोरिएशन।
ऑलराइट, लेट्स मूव नाउ टू द स्टेट ऑफ बिहार। द डस्ट स्टिल नॉट सेटल्ड After elections, weeks after Nitish government returned in Bihar, senior BJP leader Sushil Kumar Modi has now made a startling and a damning allegation that jailed Lalu Prasad Yadav was trying to poach NDA MLAs in an attempt to topple the state government.
Political slugfest in Bihar over an alleged poaching audio released by Sushil Modi. The audio purportedly has voice of RJD Supremo Lalu Prasad Yadav, allegedly dialing from jail and offering ministerial berth to BJP MLA Lalan Singh to skip speaker's election. To ensure the RJD bags all the important posts and wrests power from Nitish-led NDA.
अच्छा सुनो, हाँ हम लोग तुमको आगे भी बढ़ाएंगे वहाँ, अब बने तुम कल जो स्पीकर का चुनाव है उसमें हम लोग का साथ दो, तो उसका हम तुमको बनाएंगे, मंत्री बनाएंगे, कल तो इनको हम लोग गिरा देंगे, समझे ना।
हाँ तो पार्टी में नहीं सर, मैंने
अच्छा पार्टी में है तो एब्सेंट हो जाओ ना, पार्टी में हो तो एब्सेंट हो जाओ। कोरोना हो गया था, फिर तो स्पीकर हमारा हो जाएगा तो हम लोग देख लेंगे ना।
वो कहने लगे कि हमें साथ दो और ये स्पीकर को गिराना है, सरकार गिराना है, आगे बढ़ाए, मंत्री बनाए। हमने कहा कि सर हम पार्टी से हैं और ऐसा नहीं कर सकते।
तो क्या अब इसकी शिकायत भी आप कीजिएगा
जी,
इसकी शिकायत करेंगे?
हम बैठ के तय करें पार्टी फॉर्म क्या होना चाहिए।
Lalu is lodged in a Ranchi jail after conviction in fodder scam. Sushil Modi claimed when he dialed back the number, Lalu himself picked the call. Amid a fiery assembly seating, the unverified tape unleashed a big war of words, with the BJP accusing Lalu of misusing jail facilities to indulge in horse trading after RJD's poll loss.
अगर हमने ऑडियो को लिया है, डायरेक्ट बात हुई है, तो निश्चित रूप से ये फोन से बात।
सुशील मोदी ने भी कहा है कि उनकी भी बातचीत हुई है उनसे सीधे लालू यादव से।
देखिए, जो डायरेक्ट जब हमारे नेता ही माननीय सुशील जी ने डायरेक्ट जब बात किया है, तो फिर उसे क्या आप कह सकते हैं?
आरजेडी के विधायक जैसे बता रहे डॉक्टर्ड है, फर्जी
नहीं, ऐसा 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 कुछ नहीं।
हमने तो शुरू में कहा जनादेश की चोरी हुई, ये तो आपके सामने आसन के सामने चोरी हुई।
The RJD called the tape fabricated and result of Sushil Modi's frustration at losing the deputy chief minister's post.
Bihar Vidhan Sabha ka jab chunav hua to usme bhi janadesh ki chori hui aur aaj jab speaker ka chunav chal raha hai to bhi chori ki ja rahi hai aur khule aam chori ki ja rahi hai. Kai aise farzi voters ko farzi MLA bana kar ke piche logo ko baithaya gaya hai, isliye hum log jo hai iska virodh kar rahe hain ki kanoon se chalega, niyam se chalega sadan या बेमानी से चलेगा?
नहीं, कभी हमको बात आज तक नहीं हुआ है,
से बात करते हैं।
नहीं कभी,
आप कह रहे हैं कि
सुशील मोदी आरोप लगा रहे हैं
के? करें कोई जेल में बात नहीं, कोई फोन नहीं फकर, जेल में बात कैसे होगा?
इज आरजेडी सुप्रीमो लालू प्रसाद पुलिंग द स्ट्रिंग्स फ्रॉम अ जेल इन झारखंड वेयर हिज पार्टी आरजेडी इज इन पावर अलोंग विद जेएमएम एंड कांग्रेस, और इज द बीजेपी आउट टू डिस्क्रेडिट एनी पॉसिबल चैलेंज फ्रॉम हिज सन Tejasvi Yadav? With camera person Deepak Kumar, this is Rohit Singh in Patna for India Today.
All right. The Maharashtra government has now changed its travel norms. People arriving in the state from the capital, national capital Delhi, will now need to carry a negative RT-PCR tests. Passengers not just from Delhi, in fact, Rajasthan, Gujarat and Goa will have to undergo an RT-PCR test 72 hours before the flight. Only those who've tested negative will be allowed to exit from the airport. Those not carrying the COVID report will have to compulsorily undergo an RT-PCR test at their own cost on arrival. Train passengers entering from Maharashtra from these states will also have to carry a negative RT-PCR report. Those travelling by road shall be tested for symptoms including body temperatures. Passengers with symptoms will be made to undergo an antigen test.
The new travel guidelines apply for the train passengers as well. For all those people from Delhi, Rajasthan, Gujarat and Goa travelling towards Mumbai and Maharashtra, they need to have RT-PCR negative test report with them. If not, then on arrival, they will undergo screening tests. Post that, if symptoms are found, an antigen test will be conducted. And if the report is positive, then such passengers will not be allowed to go home. Which clearly means, to be on the safer side, passengers should ensure that before boarding, the sample collection should be done 96 hours prior. And if they have a COVID-19 RT-PCR negative test report, then they can travel safely to any part of Maharashtra. As far as the railway administration is concerned, it maintains that all its facilities are in place and it is absolutely ready for the screening of the passengers. With camera person Mahesh More, this is Pankaj Upadhyay in Mumbai, reporting for India Today.
जो यात्रीगण के पास में ये रिपोर्ट्स नहीं है उनके लिए एंट्रेंस पे हमारी तरफ से उनका बॉडी टेम्परेचर और सिम्टम्स के लिए चेक किया जाता है। यात्रियों को कोई लक्षण दिखाई दे या उनका बॉडी टेम्परेचर ज्यादा मिले तो उनको हम एक साइड में लेके यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं कि आप बीएमसी की तरफ से ये फ्री एंटीजन टेस्टिंग कैंप लगाया हुआ है, यहाँ पे उनका टेस्ट किया जाएगा और जो निगेटिव मिलेंगे उनको घर पे भेज दिया जाएगा। अगर उनमें से किसी यात्री को कोविड पॉजिटिव पाया जाता है तो उसको एम्बुलेंस के द्वारा महानगर पालिका के कोविड केयर सेंटर में भेजा जाएगा।
Well, this is unfortunate news. Senior Congress leader and Sonia Gandhi's closest aide, Ahmed Patel, passed away late last night at the age of 71. The veteran politician had been at the Medanta Hospital in Gurgaon since his health deteriorated after a COVID infection. In a tweet, his son Faisal Patel said that the Rajya Sabha MP from Gujarat died at 3:30 a.m. from multiple organ failure. He will be buried in his native village in Baharuj. It was his last wish to rest with his parents. An eight-time parliamentarian, Ahmed Patel served 3 terms in the Lok Sabha and 5 terms in Rajya Sabha. A Nehru-Gandhi family loyalist, he served as a political secretary to Congress President Sonia Gandhi for many years. As a mark of respect, the Congress party flag will fly at half-mast for the next 3 days. Ahmed Patel's funeral will take place on Thursday morning at 9 a.m. in his hometown of Piraman in Baharuj.
ढूंढते हैं तो शब्द नहीं मिलते हैं, ढूंढते हैं तो शब्द नहीं मिलते हैं। अपने घर में अपने किसी बुजुर्ग को, अपने किसी साथी को, भाई को, बच्चे को खोकर जैसा एहसास होता है, जैसा अनुभव होता है, वैसे ही अहमद भाई के जाने से हमें लगता है। मैं अपने साथियों से यहाँ कह रहा था कि अगर कभी जीवन में अनाथ होना नहीं अपने आप को समझ में आया कभी, तो आज लगता ऐसा है कि हम लोग अनाथ हैं, हम लोग अनाथ हुए हैं।
एक लंबा राजनीतिक सफ़र हमारा इकट्ठा रहा है, ये एक ऐसी कमी हुई है आज जिसकी भरपाई नामुमकिन है। वो सबको मिलाकर, सबको साथ लेकर चलने की क्षमता रखते थे। सिर्फ कांग्रेस में नहीं, देश का कोई राजनीतिक दल नहीं है जहां के नेतृत्व से अहमद भाई की अच्छे संबंध ना हो।
हमारा पूरी बुनियादी सुविधा वाला व्यक्ति आज हमने खो दिया है, जो अंकलेश्वर भरूच जिला के अंदर मेडिसिन लाइन हो या फिर एजुकेशन लाइन हो, पूरे को एक तरीके से हम फेल चुके, पूरा सिस्टम हमारा।
Welcome back. You're watching our Fact Check segment where we bust certain myths masquerading to be facts on social media platforms and WhatsApp groups. Now, there is a claim that is floating about, and you might have got it on your WhatsApp group, where it suggests that the Prime Minister has in fact announced a fresh lockdown in five states. The fact check on that, there's been no such announcement made. There is no re-locking of any state at all. Of course, there's been a lockdown at night in Ahmedabad, but no relocking of any state. So wrong. With that fact check, it's a wrap on this edition of 7 at 7. To stay with us, up next is To The Point. Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.